Hello and welcome to Upgrading SharePoint Online to SharePoint Online 2013, an Office 365 and SharePoint Online presentation brought to you by Microsoft Services and the Microsoft Partner Network. My name is John Horner and I work as a Partner Technical Consultant for Global Partner Services. I will be your facilitator for this presentation. After viewing today's session, you should be able to describe what to expect before, during, and after the Office 365 upgrade process, describe what's new in SharePoint Online post-upgrade, and understand the process of upgrading SharePoint Online sites to the new 2013 look and feel. We'll divide our agenda for today into three different lessons. In lesson one, we'll talk about the Office 365 upgrade process and what we can expect. In lesson two, we'll take a look at some of the new features of SharePoint Online and the improved user experience in SharePoint Online 2013. And in lesson three, we will dive deeper into the SharePoint Online upgrade experience and talk about upgrading SharePoint Online sites and site collections. Let's get started by taking a look at what we can expect before, during, and after the upgrade process. Although a great portion of Office 365 subscriptions and customers have already been upgraded at the time of this recording, those that have not yet been upgraded will have their service upgrade scheduled during the remainder of 2013. They will be notified via the Microsoft Online portal and by email about 4 weeks in advance, and we'll also inform you of the exact date about 2 weeks beforehand. One of the things we can do before the upgrade, or even before we've been notified that we are going to be upgraded, is to take a look at a few of the new features of SharePoint Online to become familiar with them and understand how we can use them in our current sites. This will help us determine which, if any, site collection we may choose not to upgrade immediately. Before we spend the time and effort to upgrade our site collections, we should take a look at each site and evaluate whether the sites are still needed and viable for future use. If we have old sites containing old, outdated content, we may just decide to get rid of those sites altogether and not include them in our upgrade plan. There are some known issues and design changes included in the links I will share at the end of this session that you may also want to take a look at in preparation for the post-upgrade process. While most service upgrades take less than 48 hours to complete, it's completely normal if we do need a little more time to complete the last few tasks. If your upgrade takes more than 72 hours to complete, don't worry. There isn't anything you need to do. The service upgrade team is working diligently to finish upgrading that last mailbox or administrative setting. Since all of the preparatory work for SharePoint Online on the back end will already have been completed before the upgrade begins, you won't have a planned maintenance period when your sites and documents will be in read-only mode during this upgrade. Previous versions of SharePoint Designer will not be compatible, so downloading and installing SharePoint Designer 2013 will be a good idea. And while our administrative experience will have the new look and feel after the upgrade, our existing site collections will remain as they were prior to the upgrade in something we call 2010 mode. To start using SkyDrive Pro, we'll need to run a site collection upgrade on the My Site collection. And to use other new SharePoint features, we'll need to run a site collection upgrade on each individual site. If you have Office Pro Plus 2010 as part of your current service, nothing will happen to your Office client during the upgrade. It will continue to work as usual. After the upgrade, Office 365 will not automatically install the new version of Office on your computer. There will be a new link in the Microsoft Online portal to install Office Pro Plus 2013 version. To aid in this transition, administrators will have the ability to continue offering the installation of Office Pro Plus 2010 along with the installation of Office Pro Plus 2013 until April 8th of 2014. After April 8th, the installation link for Office Pro Plus 2010 will no longer be available. SharePoint Online is welcoming several new and innovative improvements with this upgrade, including a new fluid user interface, active personal file sharing, higher storage limits for both personal and team sites, a high-end cloud app development model, and more robust tooling for admins to more easily and effectively control their SharePoint online environment. In lesson two, we'll take a quick look at just a few of these improvements. The entire user interface across Office 365, all the way on down to SharePoint Online, has been reimagined. It's easy on the eyes, easy to navigate, and easy to accomplish common tasks. We can use the callout feature, or something we call onHover, with any document in a library or from within search results to see a set of rich commands and contextual information. We can open, share, or follow documents, view a document preview, and use deep links to jump directly to content inside a document. No more open an Explorer view to enable drag and drop file upload. Now we can upload documents, pictures, and other types of files to our site by simply dragging them from our computer directly to a library on our site, such as a document library or our SkyDrive Pro library. We'll dive a little deeper into this later in the presentation, but what we used to call My Sites in SharePoint 2010 has now been divided into a couple areas we call SkyDrive Pro and Newsfeed. SkyDrive Pro is cloud storage for employees that is now a core part of SharePoint Online. SkyDrive Pro is intended to meet our usage criteria and provide organizational control. Everyone who has use rights to a personal site will get SkyDrive Pro along with 7 gigabytes of personal storage quota, which is an increase up from 500 megabytes in the previous version of SharePoint Online. With SkyDrive Pro, employees will have the ability to share and sync documents, collaborate on documents with individuals both inside and outside of their organization, and access content and information anywhere and from a multitude of different devices. While admins will still have the ability to control content lifecycle and versioning, protect against data loss and perform e-discovery, and manage access permission services. External sharing just got better. Now we can share sites, folders, and individual documents with the new guest links feature that enables users to invite others from inside and outside the company to collaborate on individual office documents. To share and collaborate, guests enter a username and password, or they can use anonymous co-authoring. In addition, we can control the contributions by the permission level we choose to grant. We might want some users to have read permission, while others have permission only to write. And we can also revoke this sharing at any time. With eDiscovery, SharePoint Online brings improved ways to help us protect our business. From a single eDiscovery management site, we can add resources and create queries to discover content across sites and document libraries, mailboxes, and discussions, and keep them in place in SharePoint Online, in Exchange Online, or in Link Online. For example, we can conduct our legal case or audit with powerful search-driven tools from within SharePoint Online-based eDiscovery Center. We can then preserve all items in place, retain items that match the queries, and export items to the industry standard format, the Electronic Discovery Reference Model, or EDRM specifications. Each legal case or audit is a collaboration site that includes a document library that we can use to store documents related to the management of these cases. When two world-class services come together, you get the benefit of both worlds. Combine SharePoint Online's document management strengths with Exchange Online's powerful email solutions and you get site mailboxes, powerful project-based inboxes that help teams organize project-related content and email into a single view. While everything is preserved in its original location as documents in SharePoint Online and email in Exchange Online. We can access site mailboxes through Outlook 2013 as well as SharePoint Online. If we don't have Outlook 2013, we can view the same content from the SharePoint Online site that loads in a site-specific Outlook web app. Only those with permissions to the project site can view the site mailbox. With Enterprise Search, we can quickly identify if we've found the right person or document before we invest more time searching beyond the search results. Users can move their cursor over a search result, and with OnHover, they can get a deep, rich look into the item without opening it. The on-hover displays a person's contact card and/or document preview by using the embedded Office web apps. For example, we can scroll through a Word document or click through slides in a PowerPoint deck. We will also see deep links within the on-hover card based on our search keywords. These take us directly to corresponding pages and slides deep inside our content. At the core architecture layer, SharePoint Online Search has greatly improved the relevancy of search results. What we get back is more assurance of finding what we are looking for. We can control the user's experience with powerful metadata-driven results and filtering options. Plus, the overall search center is extensible to our business preferred layout and design. So now that we've taken a look at what to expect before, during, and after the upgrade, and talked about some of the new features of SharePoint Online, we're all probably really excited to get our sites upgraded to take advantage of these new features. In lesson 3, we'll take a look at the upgrade process for SharePoint sites and walk through some of the upgrade scenarios. Once our Office 365 subscription has been upgraded to the 2013 experience, the only obvious difference is that the tenant administration site collection reflects the new tenant administration experience. At this point, the administrators of our tenancy have options on how and when to approach the upgrade and whether to execute the upgrades or allow site collection administrators to perform the upgrades on their site collection. But before we get into that, let's talk a little about the new look for the admin center. With the new universal Office 365 top navigation, now we can find our way without having to remember or bookmark how to get there. And it's all in a simplified single browser experience, no pop-ups, no feeling lost. We can quickly access administrative settings via the service settings link and access reporting tools all from one central location. You may be saying to yourself right now, hey, the new admin center looks great, but where do I access the services admins panels? If we take a look at the admin dropdown located at the top of the page in the new Office 365 top navigation, we can access the control panels for Office 365, Exchange Online, and SharePoint Online, as well as CRM Online if we have that subscription. Since our session today is about upgrading SharePoint Online, let's take a quick look at the SharePoint Admin Center. As you can see, this looks very similar to the pre-upgrade SharePoint Admin Center with a couple exceptions. The Settings tab has been moved from the ribbon to the left side of the page, and taking its place in the ribbon is a button called Upgrade. Let's take a quick look at the Settings tab. On the settings page, there are a few areas of interest, like here is where we now find the ability to allow external sharing and where we turn on and off information rights management, among others. But what we are really interested in for this session is the global experience version settings. Here we have options to either allow creation of old version or 2010 site collections, but prevent creation of new version or 2013 site collections. This option also prevents the opt-in to upgrade to the new version. We have an option to allow creation of both old version and new version site collections, which does by default allow opt-in upgrade to the new version site collections if old were created. Or we can prevent the creation of old version site collections and only allow the creation of new version site collections. It's very important that we select the second or third option here to allow creation of new version site collections. If we do not, we will not only have issues upgrading previously created site collections to the new version that we'll talk about later, but newly created users or users that you've created in the admin center after the upgrade will be prevented from having their SkyDrive Pro and news feeds created. Okay, now let's go back to the SharePoint Admin Center and take a look at the upgrade button in the ribbon. So how do we utilize this button, you may ask? If we tick the checkbox next to the desired site collection and then select the upgrade button, we can see that we have two options available: site collection upgrade settings and upgrade notifications. By selecting the upgrade settings, we have the ability to allow or deny upgrades of individual site collections. It is very important to complete this step, or the site upgrades we talk about in the following slides will fail. Once we have allowed the upgrading of site collections, we can select the Send Site Upgrade Notification link. And by selecting Send, we will send an email to all site administrators allowing them or letting them know that they are now allowed to upgrade their sites. Okay, so now that we have enabled the ability to upgrade sites, our SharePoint Online site collection owners will be able to choose when to upgrade on their terms. They will be able to ensure due diligence testing before committing to the new experience if they desire. But what do they need to do to upgrade these sites? Let's take a look at upgrading our My Sites. If we again take a look at our new Office 365 top navigation, we can see a link to SkyDrive. If we select the SkyDrive link, we will see the personal sites seem to set up for us. But what we will really notice is that the old My Site still exists. At this point, our tenancy is currently running on the new SharePoint 2013 platform in a state we call 2010 mode. 2010 mode refers to the previous SharePoint 2010 user experience for the SharePoint Online services. Towards the top of the page, we'll notice the message, "Experience all that SharePoint has to offer. Start now or remind me later." This is our option to upgrade this site. So if we select Start Now, we will navigate to the Prepare for Takeoff page, where we'll see an option to learn more, try a demo upgrade, and upgrade this site collection. We're going to talk about upgrading this site collection, so we will choose Upgrade This Site Collection to get the upgrade process started. After selecting the Upgrade button, we'll get warned that this is not a reversible upgrade, and we could choose to select Hold Off if we did not want to upgrade at this time. But if we select I'm ready, the upgrade will begin. And after a few moments, we'll notice that the new upgraded My Site document library, known as SkyDrive, now appears. However, if we select the newsfeed link to the left of the SkyDrive link, we'll see that the newsfeed still has the old look and feel. So if we again select Start Now, we'll be brought to the Prepare for Takeoff page, and again select Upgrade This Site Collection. Again, select I'm ready, and the newsfeed section will now be upgraded for us as well. Another new link in the new Office 365 top navigation is a link called Sites. If we select this link, it takes us to a promoted sites page where we can see links to not only our team site and public facing site, but an area where we can follow different sites and a section that will suggest sites we may want to follow. If we select the team site box, we'll be taken to our team site, which is still running in 2010 mode. Once again, we'll notice that the upgrade message at the top of the screen letting us know that to experience all that SharePoint 2013 has to offer, we can start now or be reminded later. On our team site, or any site collection that we still have running in 2010 mode, if we select Start Now in the Experience All That SharePoint Has to Offer message above, we'll again be taken to the Prepare for Takeoff page. Now, we've already seen how the upgrade process works on the SkyDrive site, and if we select Upgrade This Site Collection here, it will work the same way. So let's take a look at an evaluation site collection and select Try a Demo Upgrade. In the Try a Demo window, if we select Create Upgrade Evaluation Site Collection, we'll receive a confirmation of the request, and we will be notified in a couple days that the evaluation site is ready. Okay, so we've requested the evaluation sites. Now let's take a look at what to expect after that request. Initially, we'll receive an email verifying our request for an upgrade evaluation site. This email will come fairly soon after we make the request, and it's letting us know that we will receive another email within 24 to 48 hours informing us that our upgrade evaluation site collection is now ready and available for us to log in and evaluate. It's very important to note that the upgrade evaluation site collection will not show up in the SharePoint Admin Center, so keep an eye on our incoming emails periodically for this notice. So within that 24 to 48 hour window, we'll receive an email notifying us that our new upgrade evaluation site collection is available, allowing us to try out the upgrade of our content in a non-production way before starting our production site collection upgrades, allowing us to better understand any issues that may occur with the upgrade so we can experiment and fix them in a safe environment before moving to upgrade. Within this email, we'll find the URL of the upgrade evaluation site collection that we can use to navigate to the evaluation site and confirmation of which site this is an evaluation of. We will also find some important tasks that we should consider doing, like running the site collection health checks at the URL provided in the email. Likely it'll be something similar to this, https://domain.sharepoint.com/site/root-eval/_layouts/15/site-collection-checks.asbx. We want to run these to ensure that there are no new or remaining issues found that could impact our upgrade or post-upgrade experience. We also want to make sure we note any changes we make to resolve any issues, as we will likely need to make the same changes on the production site collection after the upgrade. We also recommend that when we no longer need the evaluation site collection, we delete it, as it is using storage space in our tenancy that we may want to use elsewhere. We want to make sure to remove and save elsewhere any documents that we may have uploaded to or created on this evaluation site collection, especially if we want to keep them, because whether or not we delete the site collection ourselves, the evaluation site collection will automatically be deleted roughly 30 days after it was created. So now let's take a look at the SharePoint Online site upgrade in process. We'll quickly take a look at the evaluation site collection we just got done talking about, and we'll navigate back to another site collection that is running in 2010 mode, and we will perform the upgrade on that site collection. So in our demo today, we're going to take a look at the tenant I've been using for gathering some of the screenshots during the slide deck. If we take a look at the admin control panel for SharePoint, I'll open it in a new tab so we can come back to it later. We'll see that there's not many site collections I have in this tenancy for one, but we want to take a look at this is our team site that during the slide deck we did the evaluation site collection of, and it is not there. We can't see the evaluation site collection here. So let's go to the sites tab we also talked about. And here is the promoted sites tab. So we see I have the team site, the public site. We have this section for sites I'm following. We're in the section where there would be suggested sites for me to follow. If I go to the team site, we'll see that we're still running on in 2010 mode, and we have the option to start now or remind me later. So if we go back and take a look at my Outlook, we'll see this is that original email that got sent to me after I requested the evaluation site collection. And here's the email that was sent to me upon its completion, letting me know that this is the site that the original site collection was copied from, to make the evaluation site. So we can take this URL, copy it into a browser, and navigate to our evaluation site. So this site and our team site are the same. This one is just running in 2010 mode. This one is running in upgraded 2013 mode. We see we have the warning here that the evaluation copy will be deleted on 9/21, which is about 30 days after I requested it. So that's how we get the evaluation site collection. We do what we want to do, we delete, then we could come back to here and we click start now and we would actually upgrade that site collection. But let's take a look at the upgrade process itself. When we come back to the site collections tab, we can see this upgrade demo site. This is one that I created for us to run for this demo. We can see that it's running in 2010 version. We talked about the settings tab. So this is the settings tab that's now on the left-hand side of the navigation, not in the ribbon. In the settings, we see all this external sharing, information rights management, start a site, etc. But what we wanted to pay attention to again was this global experience version settings. So in the global experience version settings, we have the option to allow creation of old version sites only and prevent the opt-in upgrade. We have the ability to allow creation of old and new version sites and have the ability to upgrade the old version sites. And we can here also prevent the creation of old version sites and allow only the creation of new version sites. One of these two options are the two that we need to make sure and switch to. Otherwise, when we create new users post upgrade and they click on the SkyDrive or the newsfeed section, their creation of the SkyDrive and newsfeed, or you know what's used to be called My Site, now SkyDrive and newsfeed, that will fail. But after we've made those two options there, we can go back to our site collections. And if you remember in the slide deck, we had mentioned if we click the tick the checkbox next to our upgrade demo, we have the ability here to look at our site collection upgrade settings. This is by default set to yes, because that's kind of how I set it before, is to allow. But we also have here I can disallow, but that's how we would allow the upgrade. And once we have allowed upgrade, if we take a look even at this search one, take a look at that one quick. We can see that that one currently is also set to allow upgrade. We can disallow it if we'd like, etc. But I want to go back to my upgrade demo. Click on upgrade and the upgrade notifications. This is all this does, is it sends an email. If I click send, it sends an email out for upgrade notifications. Now I did this earlier with a different site collection. So let's take a look. Maybe, it looks like that email already came back. So here's the email already. It says, congratulations, our upgrade demo site. It's been set to be able to be upgraded. So we can perform health checks, request upgrade evaluation, site collection, etc. So that lets any administrator of that site collection know that they have the ability to go ahead and upgrade. So let's go back to Manage Site Collections and let's navigate to our upgrade demo site here. And we get on the upgrade demo site, we see that again, we're in 2010 mode. We have the ability to start now or remind me later. We'll click start now for this. We have the option down here to click on learn more, which is a link that'll take us to kind of the help section, help us learn a little bit more. I'll wait for that to load quickly before I go away from that. So there's our help section to learn more. If we come back to here, we have tried the demo upgrade. This is where you click try demo upgrade. And then if we click here, we would create the evaluation site collection, similar to what we did in the slide deck. And I showed the completion of it at the beginning of this demo. I don't want to do that because I actually want to upgrade this site collection. So just like in the slide deck, we click on upgrade this site collection. We're going to be warned that, hey, this is a non-reversible thing. Are you sure you want to? If we click hold off, all it does is just kind of cancel this. We come back, click upgrade this site collection. And we click I'm ready, and away we go. It's going to process. It's going to let us know the upgrade is in process. We can see a message at the top that we're working to improve the site. Please bear with us if you experience temporary delays or glitches. And we can also see that the checkbox is ticked to automatically refresh every minute. I'm going to go ahead and refresh that now in less than a minute. It don't think it'd be done right. This site collection has very little on it. It's basically a brand new site collection. So the upgrade process is going to actually happen fairly quickly. Now your site collections, if they've actually got content, things of that nature, they may take considerably longer to upgrade. But this site collection with hardly any content on it will upgrade fairly quickly. And there we go. It already has a upgrade is successful. No errors, no warnings. Log file we can go take a look at if we'd like. We can click on this what's new link if we'd like, but let's quickly go ahead and just click on the let's see the new site. If we click on that, and there we go. There's our upgrade demo site already upgraded to 2013. As we wrap for the day, in summary, or some key takeaways possibly of what we talked about today, we talked about what to expect before, during, and after the upgrade. Key takeaways there might be that tenants will be notified 4 weeks prior to the upgrade and again 2 weeks prior with a more definitive date. The actual upgrade takes less than 48 hours to complete normally, but may take up to 72 hours or a little bit longer. Don't be alarmed if it takes a little bit longer. We talked about the Office subscription. That if you have Office Pro Plus 2010 with your current subscription, nothing's going to happen. It won't stop working all of a sudden, but also it won't get upgraded to 2013 automatically. You'll have to do that manually. And the link that would still stay available to download Pro Plus 2010 to kind of help in the transition will no longer be available after April 8th of 2014. Some of the key takeaways and what's new in SharePoint Online is, you know, we have that great new user interface. SkyDrive Pro, no longer My Sites, we have SkyDrive Pro and Newsfeed. We have great external sharing capabilities with guest links, and we have some great improved ways to help protect our business with e-discovery. Site mailboxes are a great way for different projects and teams to have mailbox-specific content associated with their project. And we talked about enterprise search and how we've got some great things coming with OnHover and things of that nature, helping us kind of get some looks inside of documents in our search results. Some of the key takeaways for upgrading My Sites, Team Sites, etc. Remember, we have to go into the admin center and make sure we enable that, the ability to upgrade these site collections. And once we do that, we can then upgrade them. We have to make sure that we allow the creation of new site collections. Otherwise, new users that we create, their My Sites or their SkyDrive Pro newsfeed, they will not be created for them. And we also talked about how to create an evaluation site collection. At the beginning of today's session, I promised you all I would provide you with some resources. Here they are. Please feel free to pause this recording anytime if you'd like to write these sources down or take note of them. If you'd like to contact Partner Services for any pre-sales or advisory support, here's the contact information. We can use the partner portal, which is http://aka.ms/mpnsupport. Or we can go through communities for support, http://aka.ms/support communities. Thank you very much for today's session. My name again is John Horner. I am a partner technical consultant with Global Partner Services. It was my pleasure to have you at this session today. Thank you.